For the second time in as many months, Donald Trump has been the target of an attempted assassination. This time he was playing golf when a lone gunman sought to open fire while hiding in bushes. He was found just in time by the Secret Service, the former president tonight vowing never to surrender.
At the golf course that bears his name, the second attempt on the life of Donald Trump.
Former President Donald Trump is safe and unharmed.
This is the man accused of plotting to pull the trigger. Pro-Ukrainian freedom fighter, 58-year-old Ryan Routh. It was 1:30 in the afternoon at his Trump International Golf Club in West Palm Beach when Donald Trump was walking between the fifth and sixth holes. One hole ahead, a Secret Service agent was securing the area prior to the former president's arrival. That agent spotted the barrel of a rifle poking through the bushes. The agent fired 4 to 6 shots at the suspect. It's not clear if Routh fired back. Dumped at the scene, an AK-47 rifle with a scope, 2 backpacks and a GoPro attached to the fence to chillingly record it all.
Those are being processed right now. The Secret Service agent that was on the course did a fantastic job.
About 450 metres back, the former president was golfing with a donor. Donald Trump was then whisked away in a golf cart. Posting to Truth, I would like to thank everyone for your concern and well wishes. It was certainly an interesting day. Also telling supporters, I will never surrender. Routh made a getaway, but within half an hour was surrounded. Routh is not a local. He lives in Hawaii. A man believed to be him was convicted 22 years ago for possession of a machine gun. His son says his dad hates Trump, like every reasonable person does. Previously, Routh had also tried to recruit fighters to help Ukraine. This latest assassination attempt comes 64 days after this. 20-year-old Thomas Matthew Crook scaling a roof outside a rally and opening fire. The election is now 50 days away and the political temperature boiling.
The threat level is high. We have increased the amount of assets that we've supported. So we live in danger times.
Donald Trump's golf club is now a crime scene. For the second time in 2 months, a gunman has been within striking range of the former president. This time, Secret Service moved fast. But tonight, the question, how could someone with a weapon get this close once again? President Biden, briefed on the shooting, says he wants to ensure that Secret Service has every resource, capability and protective measure necessary to ensure the former president's continued safety. Trump's opponent, Kamala Harris, saying, "I will be clear, I condemn political violence." Australia's Prime Minister is due in the US at the end of this week.
Everyone wants the democratic process to be peaceful and to be orderly. This incident in the United States is of concern again. It is good that President Trump has said that he is safe.
The alleged attempted assassin will now be charged. At West Palm Beach in Florida, Lauren Tomasi, 9 News.
And let's go straight to Lauren. Lauren, where is Donald Trump now?
Pete, the former president is here at his Mar-a-Lago resort, which has been sealed shut tonight. You can see police vehicles on the road behind me, and they have been lining the streets in a significant ramp up of security here. Donald Trump is due back on the campaign trail in Michigan in less than 2 days' time. As to how this assassination attempt will affect those plans, we just don't know. What is clear tonight, America is facing a frightening new normal of political violence. Pete.
Lauren, thank you.